Hey everyone, I've got a great one for you today. From strange shark-like fish that have been around for twice as long as dinosaurs, to deer as tiny as rabbits, here are 9 animals that are living fossils. Number 9. Komodo dragon. Komodo dragons are some of the most notorious lizards in the world. They're somewhere around 40 million years old, where they first live in the Lesser Sunda Islands of Indonesia. Around 900,000 years ago, they arrived in Australia as well, and got even bigger. Even though they're not the oldest animal species, they sure do look like it. They're living fossils because the Komodo dragons that are currently alive today look an awful lot like those we've seen in the fossil records, even if they are a bit larger. How large, you ask? Well, the Komodo dragon is the world's largest lizard. They can grow up to 10 feet long, and they tend to weigh around 330 pounds. They'll also eat whatever they can get their hands on. They're even infamous for taking down water buffalo. Their bites are loaded with toxic venom, enabling them to take down big game. Even if their prey is able to get away, these dragons will follow their now slowed prey scent until they're worn out, at which time the Komodo has its meal. A super cool fact is that Komodo dragons sometimes vomit when they feel threatened because, with an empty stomach, they can run faster. Number 8. Amami rabbit. Around 10 to 20 million years ago, the Amami rabbit made it to Amami and Tokuno, 2 tiny islands in Japan, to become the first rabbits within that region. Since there were no other rabbits there to compete for food, they pretty much stayed the same as they were when they arrived. So this 20 million year old rabbit species holds the title for the world's most primitive ancient rabbit. If you give it a look, you can tell immediately that it's ancient. It has odd woolly fur on its body and a strangely shaped skull and curly talons at the end of its paws. Their method of communication is also unique for rabbits. They employ various clicks and clacks to tell their brethren what's going on. However, Amami rabbits are heavily endangered, even though they've been given special designations by the Japanese government. One of their most vicious predators is the Indian mongoose, which isn't even a species endemic to Amami. These mongooses were released into the island to control the population of pit vipers. It looks like it's working, but much to the detriment of the Amami rabbit, they've been eating them as well. I guess nobody told them that they were only supposed to eat the pit vipers. Number 7. Platypus. The ever-inscrutable platypus was recently discovered to be one of the oldest mammals on the planet. When scientists investigated the platypus's genome, they found that its DNA extended back to around 166 million years ago, making it one of the first mammals to split off from the long line of reptiles. Because of this, the platypus is an excellent reminder of our ancient past, even if it is a little strange. When scientists first looked at the platypus, they thought that somebody was playing a joke on them. How else could they be looking at a creature that was apparently part otter, part duck, and part beaver's tail? They have webbed feet, large billed heads, fur on their bodies, and the guys among their species even deploy venom, which they can deploy with their claws once they retract their webbing. Also, they're the only mammal other than the echidna which is known to lay eggs. However, some things have changed during their 166 million years on Earth. In particular, the fossil records show that the early platypuses were around twice as big as the contemporary platypuses. The old ones could grow up to a meter long. Have you ever seen this 3-in-1 animal in real life? Let me know in the comments below and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Number 6. Chevrotain. Chevrotains are often referred to as mouse deer, but they are neither deer nor mice. Rather, they have their own classification. Tragulidae, I think is what it's called. We're going to go with that one. What's pretty neat is they only weigh a few pounds. They tend to be about as big as rabbits. They're some of the oldest ruminants in the world, meaning that they digest their food the same way that deer do. But unlike deer, their stomachs only have 3 chambers. In fact, given that their appearance is similar to that of other relatively modern creatures, it's startling just how crude some of the chevrotain's features are. They only have 4 toes, noses that are closer to pig's noses than anything else, and itty-bitty legs. These animals have been around for some 30 million years and during their tenure on Earth, they haven't changed with the times. Because they tend to hang out by themselves and only come out at night, scientists actually have a lot to learn about these idiosyncratic creatures. There are even some species of chevrotain that can hold their breath for around 4 minutes to escape their predators. They are very small if you compare them in size to a deer. This makes these munchkins able to avoid being the prey of big predators. Number 5. Purple Frog. When researchers first came upon the illustrations of the purple frog in 2003, they described it as a bloated donut with stubby legs and a pointed snout. Not quite high praise, but accurate nonetheless. It's a slimy, rotund creature. It's even been called the pig-nosed frog. These scientists just want to bring this frog down a peg. At least its age gives it some dignity. It's been around for almost 100 million years. The only place that you can find purple frogs are in India, and their nearest relatives hail from the Seychelles Islands. This is what gives us evidence that they've been around for so long. The only way that these two relatives could be found in these desperate places is because Seychelles, India, and Madagascar were once all one big great plot of land. Around 100 million years ago, that is. Since then, these frogs have been evolving in India independently. Purple frogs are a burrowing species, and they stay under the earth at all times except for 2 to 3 weeks during the monsoon season, when it emerges looking for love. Many communities eat their tadpoles, and when this is combined with rampant deforestation, that makes purple frogs an endangered species. But it's incredible to think that they've made it this long. Hopefully they'll make it another 100 million. What do you think about this particular frog? It's really slimy. Let me know in the comments below. Number 4. Coelacanth. Most scientists thought that the ancient fish known as the coelacanth had gone extinct at the same time as the dinosaurs. However, in 1938, a South African museum curator found the first live coelacanth that the world had ever seen, with a random catch of fish no less. This meant that the ancient fish had made it through whatever took out the dinos. However, a lot had changed in between the ancient coelacanths and the one that showed up in that net. They're old, but they're not that bright. In fact, the coelacanth's brain makes up only a mere 1.5% of its cranium, and the rest of it is just fat. Even though they're not big-brained, we probably have a lot to learn from these ancient fish. For a long time, scientists thought that the coelacanth was an ancestor of the first group of fish that sprouted legs and went on to land. But recent research suggests otherwise. In between them and us, there is something that escaped the sea. We don't have too many live specimens, nor fossils of these fish. So it's hard to determine how exactly they've evolved over the years. They're both hard to find because they live so deep under the sea. They've been found living around 2,300 feet deep, and their ancient visage is sure to shock. They can weigh almost 200 pounds and grow up to 6.5 feet long. How'd you like to run into one of those while swimming? Did you know that coelacanths have a really long gestation period? Well, just imagine being pregnant for about 3 years. Number 3. Tuatara. The tuatara looks like a dead ringer for a lizard, but it's actually in a class entirely its own. Belonging to a unique order referred to as Sphenodontia, while there were tons around during the dinosaur age, there are only two kinds of tuatara left in the world. But in the 200 million years that they've been around, they haven't really changed. Seeing lizards and crocodiles around indeed brings dinosaurs to mind, but tuatara are closer to dinosaurs than any of those creatures. Unfortunately, there are not many of these prehistoric creatures left in the world. Of those that are still alive, they're relegated to a couple of islands around New Zealand. The good news is that the ones that still exist can live up to 200 years and even become parents when they are 110 years old, like Henry, a New Zealand tuatara. Their lifestyles might have something to do with their age. Most of the time, they live a life of leisure. They like to go sunbathing or hang out in their burrows, just chilling out. When the sun goes down, they start to go after their prey, which consists mostly of beetles and other bugs. However, they can go fast if they need to. They just don't want to, it seems. Just a curious fact about this species before we go to number 2. The sex of a tuatara is determined by the temperature that the egg experiences. Really funny, isn't it? Just imagine that in summer, more men would be born and in the winter, more women. That would be a bit complicated. Number 2. Ghost shark. Ghost sharks, or elephant sharks, haven't changed a lot throughout their 400 million year evolution. And when you look at one, you might have the sneaking suspicion that you're not looking at a shark at all. That's correct. The ghost shark is actually not a shark. Rather, it comes from a group of fish called a ratfish. These so-called ratfish and sharks split off from a common ancestor somewhere around 400 million years ago. Not only is the ghost shark old, but it hasn't changed that much in that period. Biologists at the Institute of Molecular and Cell Biology recently conducted a study on its genome and discovered that it has undergone far less evolutionary change than all of the other vertebrates which they think came from the same ancestor. That's why the ghost shark holds the record for the world's slowest evolved creature. Ghost sharks are notable for their almost squid-like appearance, with eyes near the tops of their heads and a big protrusion on their snouts. These large noses actually come in handy, though. The ghost shark will use it to scour the sandy ocean floor looking for prey. Moreover, the snout is well attuned to its environment, capable of detecting motion and electric fields. Number 1. Horseshoe crab. Horseshoe crabs might look a lot like crabs, but you'd be mistaken. In fact, spiders are nearer in the family trees than all other animals. You wouldn't think that ocean dwellers with huge shells would be rubbing shoulders at the family reunion with everyone's favorite eight-legged freaks. But a few biologists from the University of Wisconsin-Madison recently verified this weird fact. This means that biologists need to rethink how spiders and other arachnids evolved. That's not where the eccentricity of these strange animals ends either. They're one of the oldest living fossils in the world. They've been around for an estimated 445 million years, which predates most of the life that we know of today. What's more, during that time, they haven't really changed much at all. The fossils we found look by and large the same as the ones that are swimming around in our oceans. Besides, their blood runs blue because of the copper that exists inside of their hemocyanin, which is a kind of protein that these creatures use to transmit oxygen within their blood. This blood is also the only source of a vital pharmaceutical chemical called limalous amebocyte lysate, which can discover whether or not certain drugs contain the bacterial toxin endotoxin, a type of toxin that makes its way into vaccines, injectable drugs, and other pharmaceutical products. I was actually fortunate enough to be able to pet some horseshoe crabs just a couple of months ago. The thing that surprised me the most about them is they actually wanted to be petted. They would come right up to you and everything. Really cool. If you're on the coast of North America or near the Gulf of Mexico, you will probably come across this species. Have you ever seen one? And if you have, did they come up to you to get petted like me? Let me know in the comments below. This has been it for today. Thanks again for watching. Which living fossil do you think is the most interesting? Let me know in the comments and click that subscribe button to stay up to date on all our newest video releases. See you again soon.